Hi there. In this demo, we'll have a look at how you can protect your applications using the Cryptolens platform. We'll primarily focus on licensing, although we'll have a quick look at the analytics dashboard and how you can process payments. So let's imagine that you've developed a new desktop application. Of course, this can be any type of application. The first thing you'd like to do is to create a new product. So you can think of a product as a way of representing your application. So each application is linked to a product. So when you develop a new application, you'll just have to create a new product in the system. Let's have a look at an existing product. As you can see, each product contains a list of license keys. And these license keys will have to be delivered to your customers so that they will be able to unlock various types of functionality. Of course, once you set this entire system up, it will be automatic, and you'll probably not have to, or in most cases, you'll not have to send these keys manually. So, but in the cases where you have to, you just go to this create new key wizard, and here you can specify what kind of features a certain license should have, and customers, and how long it should be valid, and so on. So let's go back. The first step to get started with the Cryptolens platform is to visit our help pages. I'll have them open here. So here we've listed basically so the first thing is probably to look at the Cryptolens basics guide, which goes through all the important concepts. And then if you are developing in C# or Visual Basic, then I recommend to go through the getting started guide. This will help you to create a new account, set up new products, adding some code, and so on. Of course, there's some support for C++ as well, which you can find under the client API section. However, I'll go straight to the examples section in the documentation. And here you can see step-by-step examples of with code that you can just copy and paste into your application. So essentially, the only code you need to have in your application is the key verification code for a basic setup. So here you have some examples in C# and visualbasic.net. Once you've specified all these variables with your specific ones, there are that you can find on the links above, you'll be able to get you'll get some code or something similar to what I have here. So I've just copy and paste the code for C# and added some things that we will look at later. So then the idea is, so let's say your customer has received this license key. Then they would have to enter it into your application, and then once we run the application, we'll see that this is a time-limited license, and it's valid for 29 days, and it's valid. And this is also something that you can see in the dashboard, that it has, if you click on the license key here, you can see that it has 29 days left. So it was set up with 30 days, and now it has 29 days left. Of course, if you'd like to extend, so imagine, let's say that this is a trial key and you'd like to extend that key, you just enter 10, okay. Here, let's close this. Let's recompile the application again. And as you can see, we have 10 more days that the customer can use this the software. So that was it. And of course, there are plenty of other examples that you can have a look at. So for example, some tutorials about offline verification, where the application doesn't have access to the internet, or where this access is limited. But that you can find in the examples section. So that's it. So this is really the licensing bit of the platform. Let's have a quick look at payments. So payment forms can be found here. So you click on forms and then payment forms. I've already created a payment form here, and I've set it up in such a way that when the customer, or upon a successful transaction, we will add a new feature to this license. So we could actually, as you can see in the C# code, it's quite easy to encode various types of licensing requirements. So for example, let's say that feature 3 gives them the ultimate version of the software, like all the features. So I could just type if result.licensekey.hasFeature3, then so, as you can see, they launched the program, and they can't really see this yet. But let's go to the payment form and let's copy this key. So essentially, what you have to do in your application is that you have to send them to this payment form, and you need to provide the license key that you like to upgrade. So this is just a Stripe testing environment, so we can just use some testing card. Just provide some email address, like this. And just observe that the feature 3 is still disabled, and that's why we couldn't really see anything here in the code. Let's confirm this payment. The transaction is successful, so we'll go back to the dashboard and let's refresh. And as you can see, feature 3 is now enabled. And if we launch the application again, you can see that we see this new text field or a new message here. You have all the features. So now suddenly the customer has paid for these additional features and they can now access those features instantly. Once they either reboot the application, or maybe if you have if you do periodic checks, then they will be able to receive those upgrades quite quickly. So just to sum up, what we've looked at right now is the licensing part of the platform, and the only thing it requires is that you create a new product, which is then of course your application. So in this case, this product is linked to my sample application here. And then you have to provide your customers with this license key. Either you create a new license key in this dashboard and then send it to them by mail or so. And the second option is, of course, that you use our payment forms and provide them with this license key automatically if the transaction is successful. So now let's have a look at the analytics dashboard. So the analytics dashboard is a way for you to understand where your customers are coming from. So now I don't really have that many customers, but once you start to sell your application to many different countries, you'll be able to see that you'll have various different countries will have you'll have some data for each country. Now, since this is a demo account, we just have one country here. And it's quite interesting because you can actually then zoom in into various, you can check how your request to essentially verification request, key verification request by time, and as well as see how many keys are being created. You can also see when your customers are using the application. And this is actually, this considers their local time. So if you have, if you're in Europe and you have customers in the States, you'll be able to, analytics dashboard will take that into account and give you an aggregated view of when your customers are using your application. You can also see a quick summary of how many keys are being created and how many requests have been made for a specific time period. So you can, of course, select last 30 days or last 7 days, last 24 hours, and so on. Then we have this key list, and so license key list. And here you can see which of the licenses are have the most of the requests. And then this can also be linked to customers. So you can see, so essentially each customer, we forgot to talk about that, but each customer can have, let's have a look at this customer instead, a set of licenses. And then what this panel provides you with is a way for you to tell which of your customers are the most active ones and which ones are most inactive ones. And in that case, I mean, this is kind of very useful if you like to, if you see that some of them are inactive, you might want to contact them, ask them how they're doing, and so on. So one more thing, let's have a look at these filters before we finish our overview of the analytics dashboard. So essentially filters work, they're essentially, there are three different kinds of filters. You have the keys, license keys that you can filter on, customers and countries. And for example, if you select Sweden, it will pop up here and you can of course select any other country. And then you click filter and then you'll be able to filter out or just filter on those countries. And if you click again on the filter, then this filter is disabled. Of course, you can also click on a specific license key and filter, and then you'll just see a request for that particular license key. The same thing can be done for customers. This can give you very interesting insights into how your application is being used. And then, of course, as we said earlier, it will allow you to be able to provide your customers better support. So that was a quick demo of the Cryptolens platform. I think the best and or like the easiest way to get started is to go to the help pages. Since here we've listed most of the or all the articles that you need to get started, including various types of licensing models, how you can set up payment forms, some client APIs. So just to point to add to C#, which is basic, we also have C++, if that would be required, and then various types of compliance advice, especially if you are in order to ensure that you are, for example, GDPR compliant and compliant with other types of regulations. So I think that was it. I recommend you to use the chat box that is available on each page, on every page that you visit, should you have any questions. Thank you very much. Have a good day.